Although the ultimate decision is not his to make, Akio Toyoda stated last autumn that he would like to see a brand new Celica in Toyota's range. That's not quite a confirmation, but it's also not a denial, so the Japanese carmaker might have a point. A few weeks before the winter holidays, the modern Celica was once again in the news due to a story that said it would take the place of the GR86. Furthermore, since the focus would be entirely on the future, a battery electric building might be in the works. The MR2 may be sold alongside the predicted new generation Celica, so MR2 fans shouldn't worry about it being buried. Just for fun, let us remind you that the upcoming MR2 is expected to have a battery electric platform as well, making it future-proof. When Toyota discontinued the Celica in the early part of 2006, it was the last time we heard about it in a formal setting. At that point, the model was in its 7th generation, sharing a platform with the Prius, Corolla, Avensis, RAV4, and a plethora of other cars from the same era. It had a front-engine, front-wheel drive arrangement. Many whispers over the past 18 years suggested that it would be brought back, inspiring a number of rendering artists to create a variety of unofficial designs. The one we reviewed over a year ago had a body similar to a Supra and a face similar to the most recent Prius. The most recent one, which was posted on YouTube by A1 Cars, uses a similar formula. It is evident that the rendering artist used the body of the GR Supra to create these digital renderings, slightly altering the car's front and back ends as well as its profile to give it a more contemporary appearance. It retains its sharp snout, and from some perspectives, it resembles a Lexus. Though, to be honest, this CGI model is more deserving of the Supra name than the Celica, but whatever. For what it's worth, we think this is a compelling suggestion, especially since it rejects the crossover trend. Regardless of body type, we believe the automotive industry needs more models with a low profile. However, would a possibly upcoming Celica persuade you to ditch that high-riding car in favor of it?